Hello friends, welcome to today's video and my Peloton Corner. As you can tell from the title of today's video, I'm going to be telling you about my experiences completing the first week of the 5-week Discover Your Power Zones program. I have done a number of reviews of different aspects of the Peloton on this channel. I will link down below and try to link up here to my Peloton playlist. I have done the Total Strength program. I have done the sleep meditation program. I did a review of my first 30 days with the bike. I reviewed a number of instructors. So again, you can go to my Peloton playlist to find all of that. But one of the things that I get requested the most is to try the Power Zone programs. And I was intimidated by it for so long. It just seemed like such a training kind of thing. And although I have been working on the bike, I don't come from a super athletic background. I don't want to say I'm not athletic because I do find that I'm becoming more so, but I'm not somebody who has like been involved in training all my life. I basically don't have that in my background. So it seemed a little intimidating to me. But I had it suggested a lot, and somebody also pointed out, which is true, because one of my concerns was that it's built as a 5-week program, and with the new way that the programs are set up, I was worried that I would get behind and then wouldn't be able to do all the classes. I'm a little bit of a completionist in things, so it would drive me nuts if I had to skip a class. But someone pointed out that all of the classes that are there are on demand anyway, so even if you miss them as part of the program, I could still do them. So I don't know, I think just also coming off of riding with Dennis for a number of rides, I decided to give it a go. And so far, I am happy that I have. So one of the things that I find for myself is that I am intimidated by things where I don't know what to expect from them. So if you are like that, or you just want to know more about my experience in the first week, I'm going to tell you all about it so that you know what to expect, and just a few of my thoughts. If I had taken a video of myself either before the first day of the Power Zone program or before the second day, which is when you do your FTP test, I would have looked like that girl in the Peloton commercial that got so much grief because it looked like she was being forced to start doing something. I was nervous. I actually took an extra day longer than I should have before doing my FTP test because I had it in my mind that I had to be like perfect. I had to have like my nutrition in check the day before and a good amount of sleep. And I think all that is important if you're trying to like hit some kind of goal like an athlete, but I just needed to do the test. But we'll get to that in a moment. So the very first day, I took some notes here, which is why I'm looking down. The very first day was an intro ride with Matt. And it was new to me to not have cadence and resistance ranges up on the screen. That was really difficult at first, although I do find now that I've gotten into more of the rides that those are there. So it seems a little hit and miss on whether they give you cadence and resistance on your screen. I am glad that I rode with Dennis before starting to do this program because it does seem like they do a lot of the spin-ups as warm-ups, which Dennis does all the time, which makes sense because he's also a Power Zone instructor. I found it really hard to estimate zones. So in Power Zone training, there are 7 zones, with 1 being the easiest and 7 being the most difficult. So what the FTP test on day 2 of the program does is it automatically takes your test and sets those ranges for you and puts them on the screen, which is really good because this would be very difficult to do if you were not riding on a Peloton or hadn't done that test and you were trying to estimate them. Because they talked about how the first zone is just super easy. It's kind of where you warm up. The second zone, they said it's easy to talk and you could go forever. Well, I don't know about you. I couldn't go forever on the bike in like any zone. I don't know. And then 3 is starting to sort of like take deeper breaths. But at one point, I think they said you could still go all day. And to me, that's not really true of zone 3. Zone 3 is quite hard, but then some other instructors have said you could go for an hour. I don't know. But then some of like, I heard zone 4 is breathing deeply and can only go for an hour. So I found that there was a little bit of inconsistencies in all the different rides I did on how to estimate your zones yourself. So I think if you are somebody who is doing sort of just the app and using your own bike, it would really help to do some actual reading about what the different zones should feel like. A lot of the songs on that first day I didn't know. I'm a huge rider for music, so that can be a little tough. I think that's going to be one of my obstacles as we go through this program, is I don't really get to choose the music that I like. I think on the first day I was estimating too lightly for my zones. I wasn't giving myself enough of a challenge. And I also found one of the things I found on the first day, and this continued through the week, So far we haven't done a lot of out of saddle work, and oh my goodness, I do find my butt starts to hurt. Like, I went through all the normal, you know, first couple weeks of Peloton, getting my butt broken into being on the saddle, but doing so much in the saddle work through the power zones in the first week, I did find my butt was starting to ache again a little bit when I would get onto the bike. The second day is the FTP test, and once again, I was happy that I had done a lot of riding with Dennis previously, because Dennis was the one doing the 10-minute warm-up, and then also the 20-minute test, and because I really enjoyed riding with him, I built up a lot of trust with him, so I really felt like he was going to give me the direction that I needed to know to do the test well, but I still didn't really know what the test was going to be, and that was giving me a little bit of, I want to say anxiety, that's probably a little too, like, probably not anxiety, but a little bit of worry. I did appreciate that in the warm-up, he kind of gave you an idea of what you were going to do and like how you were going to be in the different zones through the test and what they were going to ask of you. But I was still anxious about it. And for me, having expectations gives me a level of comfort. He did talk about leaving it all on the bike. You know, you were going to be giving like a 10 out of 10 effort for this. And if you had anything left in you at the end of the 20 minutes, then you hadn't gone hard enough, which again makes me a little nervous. But I did appreciate in the warm-up giving a bit of a heads up. So basically what it is in the 20-minute test is that you start out in zone 3. God, now that I even say this, I'm starting to question myself. I think you start out in zone 3 because he said starting out in zone 2 isn't high enough. Starting out in what you estimate to be zone 4 will be too high. But they basically break the 20 minutes down into like 5-minute sections and you increase. Although I did find you were increasing through the whole thing. So it was hard. I was pushing it and I was feeling like, okay, I'm getting there because I'm getting close to the end and like this is hard, but I can make it. And then the last 3 minutes, he kind of wanted you to do 20-second spin-ups every one of the 3 minutes. And the first one I did, or just giving like extra effort, the first one I did and that burned me out. And I actually did find I had to lower the resistance a little bit and not do those other 20-second pushes just to get through to the end of the ride. But I did feel that I gave 10 out of 10, left it all on the bike, max effort that I could. And I mean, I did PR on that ride, which I guess is what you should expect for doing an FTP test, especially for the first time. So as I mentioned at the start of this, I am not an athlete and, you know, we're not in this to compare anything with each other, but my first FTP test, I came out with a 118. I know people who are like actual crazy cyclists are up into like the 200s. That's where I am and I have room to improve and that is wonderful. The third day was an endurance ride with Christine. I've ridden a couple times with Christine before. I do find her very calming and I found this to be the same. And I am seeing what people mean about the power zone rides being very predictable. Like, somebody I read once said after doing so much power zone training, they would go to like a, you know, 20-minute rock ride, and it just seemed like crazy how much was being done. Because in these endurance rides, you basically do a warm-up, and the warm-up is always a song at like zone 1, and then you get into the second song and you do some spin-ups, and then the next song you do sort of a build, and then you go between zones. And in the endurance rides, from what I understand, it tends to be like zone 2, zone 3, and you do them for like 2 to 3 minutes each. And that's what you're doing. So it's very like set. It's not sort of like 20-second like push and up and down and out of the saddle and doing all these things. It's, you know, setting levels and staying there, which makes sense because it's endurance training. The fourth day was interesting because it was back with Matt again, and it was listed as a 20-minute low impact ride. And I actually think that I did this ride with Matt months and months ago without really knowing that it was part of the Power Zone program. And it was interesting because I was going into it thinking, oh, this is a 20-minute like low impact ride. This is going to be easy. But it was training because in this ride, he has you unclip one leg and pedal with the other leg and then go back and forth. So a couple things I would recommend to you if you are going to this program and you're watching this video before you do. If you are somebody who needs to tighten up your cleats every once in a while, because I do, make sure you do that prior to this ride, because with the clipping in and clipping out and also with only pedaling for one leg, you really want to make sure that your cleats are in the right place and you're able to like clip in, clip out without a lot of like wobble to it. And also, I would actually take the time to unclip. I'm not coordinated with it. Yes, I did have to like stop the pedals to clip and unclip, but I did realize that as compared to when I did this ride before, I left my other leg clipped in and just thought I was pedaling with the one that we were focused on. But I think I was still helping with the other leg because this was a lot harder when the other leg is entirely unclipped. So even though this was a low impact ride, this was quite a workout. And I did find that it was actually one of the times where I almost had to catch myself from holding my breath when I was doing certain things because it did take a lot of concentration and just felt entirely different. I obviously don't use my hamstrings as much as I use my quads when I'm pedaling, and you really feel that when you're doing it with just one leg. And finally, day number 5, which is the last day of the first week, there's 2 rest days built in, not at the end, you sort of take them throughout. It was with Olivia, who I had not biked with before. I quite enjoyed her. Again, it was an endurance ride, so it was the, you know, longer warm-up and then the zone 2 and zone 3. I think the biggest thing for me is going to be it's not necessarily my music, but I do like appreciate hearing new things. It didn't completely put me off entirely. I think what I found fun during this ride is we did a part at the end that was high cadence for like a sustained period of time, like 6 or 7 minutes or something, over 100. And in the rides I've all done previously, usually getting up that high was intervals and not very long. So it's sort of interesting to find within myself the power to keep something at a high cadence for a long sustained period of time. I actually found it kind of fun because I don't get that often in any of the other rides that I've done. And I was definitely sweating at the end of this. When I went into my first endurance ride, and like, you know, you're at zone 1 and zone 2, I was thinking like, okay, I'm not going to get as much of a burn out of these rides in terms of like calories and heart rate. But no, my heart rate gets up there. I am sweating by the end of it. It is definitely a good workout, and I am enjoying this a lot more than I expect it to. I found it's really nice to have a program set so I don't need to think each day about what is it that I'm going to do. What class am I going to choose? What am I in the mood for? Do I want to push myself today? Do I not want to push myself today? It's just there. I just go to the next class. I will add on a 5 or 10 minute cool down ride depending on how much I put into it, because the cool downs and stretches aren't part of it. But I will always put on a cool down ride. I think the only time I didn't put on a cool down ride was the very first endurance ride with Christine, the only one this week, I guess. She actually had the zone 2, I believe, at the very end for a couple of minutes before zone 1 for a minute, so I felt fairly cooled down. But I, you know, stack those onto there, but it's nice to just go to the bike and know, you know, what I'm gonna do is already set for me, and it's set up in a way to train me, and that's really nice. I enjoy that. I do wish they had more. I know there's another Power Zone program as well, and I guess you can go back and forth. But I do like the idea of having these programs set up, so that you can work towards goals, especially for someone like me who doesn't really know how to set that training up for myself. So that has been week 1. I'm looking forward to week 2. I do hope you enjoyed this video. I'm planning on doing one every week. I hope you guys will look forward to that. I know that I would enjoy watching this kind of thing if I was interested in the programming and didn't know sort of what to expect from it. So if you enjoyed this, please give me a thumbs up. Let me know down below if you've done the Power Zone training or not. I'm also curious as to like, if you are somewhat of a beginner like me, how much did your FTP test change over the program? I don't know what to expect, and I mean, that's kind of fun. I have no expectations for this. I'm just doing what they ask me to do, but I am a little bit curious. Let me know all of that. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and if you've hung in this long, I will also show you my Peloton name. Feel free to add me on there, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye!